Well, hey, how's it going, Forum? Great to have your company once again. I've been out of action for a little while, doing some personal stuff.
And studying at das Regensburgh Technical Instituten.
Here we have an exclusive interview with an old friend of mine from a long time ago. He has his finger on the pulse of political situations going on around the world. And I thought I'd ask him a few questions about what's going on in the state of Israel and the state of Zionism here in 2011. Well, we have in the studios here today, and of course coming to us live from Canada, we've got C4 on the line. How are you going today, sir?
Doing well, Steve. How are you today?
My first question, sir, is what do you feel is the future of the United States of America, given that hope and change hasn't worked out too good for them?
I think the future is military dictatorship. Seems to me that the military-industrial complex is of primary importance to the central authority in government, and I think it's only a matter of time before it happens that it turns out as being a military dictatorship or a coup.
Who do you think was the last president who actually cared about the American people to serve in the American government?
Probably JFK. JFK seems to have had an agenda to put America on the path that it was supposed to be on, but well, we all know how that turned out. And I think that his assassination had everything to do with him being a little too American for the powers that be.
Why is it that so many Christians today would pray and die for the state of Israel, even though they've got no connection to Israel, they've never been there, that they basically have a completely different religious belief to the people of Israel? Why is it that so many American Christians are so fanatic about a country that doesn't even like them?
I think American Christians have had their Christianity redefined for them by Zionist interests that have no vested interest in Christianity or Judaism, simply because a lot of these people are atheist in origin and want to lend a political nod for Israel using Christianity in the United States for support. I think a lot of the Christians in the United States have been theologically compromised by the efforts of the atheist Zionists that infiltrate their faith. It's not Christian at all. It's nationalism. Now, if you go in the most parts of Europe, you won't find many Christian Zionists. You won't find many Christian Zionists in Canada. You won't find many Christian Zionists anywhere outside of the United States. That's because people like Joel Osteen. Gee, isn't that a good Christian name? Joel Osteen is a Christian preacher. Now, if that isn't the biggest joke you've ever heard, here's an even bigger one. Just by changing the spelling of his last name slightly, he was able to pass himself off as a Christian. And now we have all of these hicks following this pseudo-Jew who's laughing at them while probably sending 90% of the Christian contributions from his church to Israel. We've got another Jim Baker on our hands here, and they keep buying into this because it's all under the name of God, and we all know God blessed America. And since God blessed America, he must be an American lover. So since he's an American lover, if the preacher tells you that Israel is supposed to be included, well, let's put it this way. The Zionists attack the West because they hate its guts. That's what it's all about. What do you think about that?
So, sir, how about these modern-day Zio-Christians? Are they even Christian? Are they even Zionist? Are they even Jewish? A lot of them seem to be, as you said before, they just seem to be patriots for the United States. But I find that hard to believe also. I can't see how they love the country at all if they allow it to go down into ruin the way they are.
Well, it's like this. One day, this Christian woman comes into a room. I look at her profile picture, and it shows a Bible wrapped in an American flag. I said, hey, don't you think that would be offensive to Christians that were not American? She said, oh, that's not important. Flags don't matter. We're all Christians. I said, great. So no one discriminates against nationalism when you're in the United States so long as you're Christian, right? And she said, yeah, you're right. I said, well, how about this experiment? Why don't you wrap an Iranian flag around your Bible and walk into your church of acceptance and see how that goes? I wouldn't do that. I would never do that. I said, well, why wouldn't you do that? Well, we're not really kind of like, you know, those Middle Eastern type of people. They're not really Christians. I said, well, there's a few Christians inside Iran, I'm sure. And, well, it's not about nationalism, like you say. So as long as they're Christian, they're good with you. I don't think I'd be received very well in my church if I went in there with an Iranian flag. You see, it is about nationalism.
The interesting thing is that it is about nationalism, that's what you say. So how is it that most of America is run by the Zionist entities already? They don't care about America. They don't care if America lives or dies. I hear tell there's over 1,300 bridges and dams that are in dire need of repair, and they're not being repaired. The people in charge are not repairing America. The things that need to be upgraded around the country are being left to rot. So how is it that these people supposedly running America, the ones who in charge of America, and as you and I know, they're all Zionists, how is it they can even proclaim that they love America when they're letting it go to such ruin? I really don't get that.
There is no Christianity in the United States. It's all nationalism. If you ask them to throw their flag away or their Bible, you'd have a pile of Bibles in the middle of the street, man. Trust me on this. If Americans fear poverty much more than the wrath of God. They fear being communists much more than the wrath of God. They fear, you know, no cable TV than the wrath of God. Your religion is used as kind of a pseudo-foreign policy, a reason to vindicate their hatred that has been impregnated into their mentality through Zionist media, right?
Well, sir, one of the most bizarre suggestions that I've heard recently is, in fact, that the word Jew can be offensive to Jewish people. How does that work? Because I always thought if you call somebody a Christian, they'd be proud to have that label on themselves. But whenever you say, oh, you're a Jew, they're like, oh my God, you can't say that. You can't say a Jew. Why not? Isn't that your religion? Why is it that they get so defensive about calling them a name when it is actually a descriptive name? It's not a derogatory term at all. I really don't get it. There seems to be some kind of a paranoia mindset in these people that you can't say anything about them, otherwise you're going to get sued or driven off, or like that poor dog that walked into a government building. They started to stone it and they started to chase it out, saying it was infected with an evil spirit. What kind of people are we dealing with here, sir?
Zionists are always afraid of the word Jew. They're afraid that an actual Jew might show up.
Well, sir, why do we have a situation where Canada is appearing to be pro-Israel?
Canada isn't pro-Israel. Harper is pro-Israel. Harper isn't the peep. Harper's the puppet government that has been put in place here in Canada by interests down south, namely AIPAC. Is Harper a Jew? No, Harper isn't a Jew.
Now, you've caused a lot of controversy just recently talking about the fact that most Hebrew language is originated from the Greek language. And in fact, you point to the book by Yehuda, the professor. Can you tell the audience out there listening a little bit more about the facts behind Hebrew language being originated from the Greek language? I find this fascinating.
Well, ancient Hebrew seems to be a dead language. It wasn't a common language. It wasn't linguistically very prominent in the ancient world, and had been relegated always to very, very, very small sect of Judaism all over the Middle East, and it never did survive. But the modern incantation of Hebrew is derived from Greek and Arabic. But in Mr. Yehuda's book, in which he's perfectly qualified to make the studies that he did and the findings as a linguist and as a well-known linguist coming from academia, there's no doubt that this book was blacklisted by the people that were not interested in having any historical truth to what exactly it is that they're supposed to be. And we might note that Joseph Yehuda was actually himself a Jew, and I find it astounding that he would publish a book like this. Hebrew came from, it was a cultural thing, not a religion. Its origins are from Africa, specifically southeastern Africa. It never was a religion until it was, quote, transcribed in ancient Greece in Thessaloniki, right, by a bunch of former apostles. And that's the closest word I can associate with him, because they weren't really apostles. They were representatives of the many gods that existed at the time. Now, these people, under the governmental policy, would tour the entire region looking for theocratic enlightenment. They ended up in Mesopotamia, bringing back the knowledge of the Sumerians, and then assembling all of this into some bunk religion called, Hebrew and Judaism, which never existed. But the fact of the matter is, the so-called Jews that resided in Northern Europe, specifically through the Slavic world, had no real attachment to these people, but you know that. The Ashkenazis are about as Jewish as my cat.
Well, sir, my simple question, do you support the stop funding of Israel? Do you support America's cease funding for the illegal entity, which is known as Israel? Do you support that?
Supporting Israel, in my mind, is supporting terrorism, and the policy of the United States is to do everything they can to interfere and to persecute people who are in direct funding of terrorism. And we can certainly accuse the Israelis of being terrorists. If we can go back to the Stern Gang, the formation of Israel, they were defined as terrorists. So in essence, the United States is funding the very thing that it has legislated against.
Well, sir, a bit of your background goes into aerodynamics. I won't get into specifics of how and why, but you certainly do have your finger on the pulse of what's happening in the world today. Where do you see us headed as a globe, as a people, as a planet Earth? Where do you see that things will boil down to a crunch point? Do you think that's going to happen at all?
I think that the world is turning into a more global political entity. The internet has certainly brought about a digital democracy where people don't have the interference of big media conglomerates. People now have a more direct method of talking to each other, to the chagrin of the media mongols and people that are interested in putting a media out there that is construed to suggest a certain political stance. But I think that the world is going to get to the point where Israel will be relegated to a very, very distant priority on the tables, and rather be made unimportant geopolitically, because of the fact that a lot of what's gone on in the Middle East geopolitically has Americans in a position where they can't claim Israel's the only democracy in the Middle East. They can't claim that Israel is the only ally in the Middle East. They're basically a redundant entity now in American foreign policy. And the question remains is, are they worth the price in consideration of the other friendly nations to the United States in the Middle East?
Well, sir, Mr. C4, you've been a good friend for many, many years. You're a very intelligent man. It's been a privilege knowing you, that's for sure, all these years, and indeed for many more years to come. It's a very rare thing to come across a person like yourself in what is now Zionist-occupied government in both Canada, the UK, Australia, and the United States of America. We seem to have a Zionist-occupied government, a ZOG, in all of these entities. And as sad as it is, I can't see it changing anytime soon. We were promised hope and change from Obama. And what did we get? We got nothing. We got more of the same. We got more AIPAC and more ADL policies pushed on us. Just like to say thank you for informing myself and everybody in this forum. You're very instructive, and the world is a better place with you here. That is for sure.
Anytime.
Well, that's all for me for now. As always, take care, God bless, stay safe, and above all, stop funding Israel. Ciao for now.